Hello, so this will be a video about the beginning of the game and how to advance faster because, you know, time is important. You don't want to waste hours and hours in the beginning. Now, this is the full map that you can access in the beginning. We also have two big slimes over here that you can feed and they will explode and give you something nice. You also have a lot of other things around the place, but collecting resources is the fastest way to advance. But before you do all of that, by the way, this is where you can store stuff in your equipment. I mean, you don't sell it, you just store it. But let's go over the base layout. First of all, don't bother with the pink slimes. They're very, very cheap, so you might want to collect them, the plorts from the nature, from the open world, but don't bother with them. Instead, focus on the cotton slimes. Ooh, they're really hungry. And also upgrade it to a level 2 wall as soon as you can. And this one, well, I had the pink slime, so I'll replace them with something else in the near future. Otherwise, just put more cotton slimes. Over here, we have the vegetable patch. Yes, we have vegetables, fruits, and chickens or meat. As you can see, I've upgraded it for the nutrient soil. The other ones are important as well, but I think this is a little more important because you just get a lot of materials. Or, you know, carrots. And this is again is the fruit patch, which is the cube berry. Which again has the nutrient soil because you get a lot more. Sometimes you'll spend a lot of time exploring and you don't have time to collect them at short intervals. So yeah, the first upgrade is better like this. And then we have the tabby slimes. Oh, so adorable. Oh, I like them. So during the night you find the phosphorus slimes and the tabby slimes are somewhere around here. Very easy to get. They also have a level 2 floor, so they don't jump out. If they jump out, they can either eat your food or they can eat plorts and they'll hybridize. Hybridizing is very good, but only in certain situations, and I'll speak about these situations right now. Normally I give them some chickens and the rest of the chickens I put over here in the breeding pen. Now, this is a little bit of a how should I put it, a controversial subject. You need meat for the cats, so I also have the vitamizer and spring grass, and also piles are not needed. So you need chickens and a rooster. I have two rooster or even three of them because they will grow old and then they will not be able to, you know, it's not going to... Okay, and I guess this will be enough chickens. Back, back, back. And your kitties will not eat so much, but I recommend you have at least 10 of them. At least 10 slimes in each pen. And they'll go on top of each other and they'll try to escape. But to be honest, I like them so much I brought more. And I'll show you why in a second. Also, we can take more chickens. I think you need probably one chicken per rooster. And yeah, we have enough chicks anyway. Oh, hey, 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 hey. Well, I guess it caught the chicken in the air. See, they can still escape, so you have to be careful. They will jump up and down, they will make a little ladder. And I'll show you about hybridizing. So hybridizing is a very important mechanic. So that's kind of like my initial layout. One level 1, two level 2, vegetables upgraded for the maximum yield, maximum production, fruits, chickens with a few roosters in it, and also the two other upgrades. And then I just have another one over here for fruits. Because fruits are very important in the beginning, and I'll show you why in a second. Of course, the nutrient soil is there as well. So, two fruits, one vegetable, and one chicken coop. Also, let's speak a little bit about the sleeping system. Sometimes you need to sleep to skip the time in order to, you know, get the plorts, make everything grow back like the fruits. For example, everything will regrow back almost every day, so if you don't have anything to do, just skip time by sleeping over here. It's not much of a tip, but it's very important. So when you skip and sleep during the day, you can just go back and collect everything you need, like vegetables, I mean, general food, plorts, or slimes. That's a cabbage, by the way. So over here you see the value of each Lord, over time it will drop dramatically because look at this. This is 15 for the cut and plot, right? Was a good sell, but I think over time, as you can see, it's dropping, so you will not be able to use the pink plorts or the cotton ones for a very, very long time. Not even the tabbies or the phosphorus one are very, very good in price. So you'll have to switch to other rarities, so the more you sell, the more it will drop. Oh, by the way, you get the phosphorus slimes during the night, and after you get them, you go over here into your cave and put them over here. If you put them outside without building the necessary protection, they'll just poof away. They'll disappear. Okay, so what do I mean by this? I mean, I wanted to move the phosphorus slimes out here, but you need a lot of work. You need the higher walls where you can reduce the agitation. You also need the air net, more or less, but you most likely need a you 100% need a solar shield. So, the question is, why shouldn't you hybridize every slime? Well, it's simple. At some point in the game, you'll just want to use the auto feeder, the plort collector, and some other things that will become available to you. So, if you hybridize them, they'll be too big to fit into one of these things. And also, they'll be very, very hard to control. Because they'll get stuck on your gun. Anyway, you can play with that a little bit, but you'll notice that it's a lot harder to manage. So, how do you hybridize? Well, you just feed them the plort of the cat. Look at how cute they are. So let's hybridize everything over here. As you can see, I have a lot of them. I don't think you can put them anywhere else. Besides, this is free real estate. It's so much space over here. And what did we do? Now the phosphorus slimes will eat fruits, but also the tabby slimes will eat fruits. So what does that mean for us? You'll see. I'll leave all the plorts over here. Sooner or later, they'll all hybridize. So it doesn't matter. Also, let's leave them with a lot of food. So as you can see, they're producing the tabby slime, but also the phosphorus slime plorts. So two plorts for the price of one fruit. Which is great, right? Eh, you know it is, but you know, they won't eat meat. But again, for the future, we'll need very, very sensitive stuff. So what do I mean by that? As you can see, upgrading and doing all of this will require specific plorts. Now, if you're wondering what should you upgrade first, it will be this one, the tank booster. So you can carry more. And very, very importantly, you will need the jetpack. So, why is it so hard to collect? This is why it's hard to collect. Imagine you're in the pen and trying to collect. Yeah, this will be a nightmare if you do it in the pen. Anyway, you'll get bored at it at some point. So, let me see. I need... Okay. Oh, I need 3 more tabby plorts. Well, I guess I should leave more tabby plorts on the floor so all of them get hybridized. But look at the production, that's insane! So this is a little harder to set up. I mean, you probably need 20 or 30 minutes to do it anyway. And you can sell the plorts in the meantime. But once you get it, it will be huge wins for you. So we have, let's say, 400, right? So that's 600. Of course, their value will drop at some point. And we're still not done. So I would say you have over 1,000... over 1,000 money with just a little bit of fruit. And we can do this trick a lot of times, and of course we can even bring more of them in here. But I guess it just depends on how much fruit you can produce, which is not a lot. Or you can produce more fruit, but again, it's not really worth it. So, tank booster, first upgrade will do. And now we can collect more. Of course, I'll bring about more 10 tabby slimes over here when they spawn. It's only day 5. are you doing over here? I guess they're just happy to be together. Looks like all of them hybridize. That means I can sell the rest. Of course, this is not very efficient as you can see, but it's the best way to do it in the beginning. So let's say you get more than 1,000... depending on the price, more than 1,000 per day. Yeah, let's just put all of it over here, so we have a lot of money. And now with that money, we'd upgrade the fruit production, of course. By the way, you can collect the fruit, they don't have to drop from the tree, you can collect them as they are. I think you might get the lower production of fruit, actually get the same. Yeah, you just can collect it early. From what I saw, they ate everything, the little monsters. Okay, well, I'll leave them to that, so as you can see, that's the best way to make a lot of money in the beginning. Now, let's go explore a little bit. I don't want to explore too much. Well, I guess I can show you a few more things and we can talk about them, but very, very shortly. So, the jetpack is your next thing, your next big thing. By the way, let me get away. So you're kind of looking to get the jetpack, but also the other ones are pretty good as well. And you need this one, the resource harvester, to be able to harvest the salty water and the other thing. Oh no. Grow big, my little child. My little pet. There are not a lot of secrets, so here you'll find a lot of tabbies and chickens. Here you'll find a lot of fruits and vegetables and... well, I guess it'll be hard for you to find this slime. Actually, I'll not even show it, because... you just need to go into a cave, it's not so hard. I just want to show a few more things. So you have to go every day over here, collect the carrots, don't let the pink ones eat them. The pink parts are not worth so much, so in a way you might want to throw the pink ones in the ocean, but again, that's too cruel, so I'll not do it. I'll just leave them alone, but I'll take their carrots. Okay, here is a carrot. And now you can collect these resources over here, which probably will be needed in the future. And by the way, you don't toss those in the ocean, you suck them in and then you do it like that. You need the gold at some point. I mean, you need a lot of it, of course. But you don't destroy those, you just smash them against the wall and you get rewards like that. I also have the rainbow slimes. Oh, we can do this right now. So as you can see, that will be your deep brine. So whenever you are over here, you will have to go to the chicken nests. Oh, not the rooster. I would like to collect him, but I don't have time. So sometimes there will be a lot of rainbow slimes, which will be kind of trying to eat you. They have in their diet the ranchers. And they'll destroy the entire population. Otherwise, if you leave them alone like this, they'll eat fruit or vegetables, they'll hybridize, and then it will be a mess. So it's just better to control the population whenever you can, otherwise, just don't worry about it. This central area has most of the resources. And I just want to show you another rare one. By the way, you can also go up there, through there, or there. And you just come over here, collect the plorts and the food and everything else you need. Of course, we don't need much right now because we have done everything we need, but we need to collect vegetables in order, vegetable or fruits, to feed the big ones. I'll do that in the next video I'll post of my Let's Play. Hello, little guy. You are very big and hungry. And that's another Gordo. I kind of forgot to... I don't know why it doesn't show on the map, but I guess it shows now. Well, like I said, the plink ports are basically worthless at this point. I Ah, don't worry, we'll feed all of them in the next video maybe. So, vegetables. So, I'm trying to show you a rare resource. It's actually not so rare, but there is only one of it. Well, I keep getting distracted. By the way, this is to store your plorts, so I guess it's a good idea to store them. Also your water. You're coming with me? Why didn't it work? Anyway, it worked now. I don't think you can store the chickens. That would be hilarious. You can probably store the... no? No. I guess we just need more upgrades overall. Yeah, you can also climb over here on the other side. I forgot where that thing is. Oh, it's over there. Huh. I cannot find it for whatever reason. Oh, there it is. Let me see if I can find that other resource over here. Okay, sorry about this, it shouldn't be long. Huh, I thought it was somewhere over there. Well, I completely forgot what it is, but it was some kind of a solid jelly thing. Which you can extract using your weapon, your tool, I guess. Just don't remember where it was. I guess you can explore and see what it was. It was somewhere around here, because it fell down the thingy. Anyway, I think that's all I wanted to show you for today. Oh. It doesn't it work? Okay, now it worked. That's all I wanted to show you today. Just explore everything and do everything you can. Increase your production and then you'll be able to feed the Gordos and then you'll be able to access new stuff. Also find the Hydro turret and that was in the caves, I think, somewhere around here. It's supposed to protect you against the rainbow slimes, but I don't think it's so important. Oh, I didn't get this one, so it's a schematic. I guess that's just for the decoration. Yeah, well, I guess the video had the purpose of showing you these things over here, so you can find technology in those. I guess you have to search the island super, super carefully so you get everything. Throw them in the water. Otherwise they'll multiply uncontrollably and they will ruin your adventures in nature. I'll save you, kitty. In case we don't have any more carrots left. Yeah, right now I'm just getting enough fruits and vegetables to feed the Gordos, and like I said, that will be shown in my let's play how I feed them. Yeah, really sad about not finding that very thing I was searching for, but it... Okay, let's give it one more go. Anyway, we are still showing stuff. They're all hybrids over here. Or maybe it doesn't spawn so fast. I don't know what the deal was with that thing. Huh. Okay, let's explore a little. Oh. Okay. I guess you can wait until you can see the phosphorus slime. I don't hear any evil music, so that means we don't have the rainbow ones. You can kind of cheese it with even without the jetpack. If you really want to see what's on top of that thing. Yeah, I don't really remember how I got that. How I got that. But there is supposed to be one of the jello stones on top of this, one of these things over here. I think. I guess I remember when I stopped recording. Anyway, that's the basics of the game. Sorry I showed too much of this. And yeah, like I said, you just have to explore more and more and more and kind of prepare to get more food. Kitty. I just like playing the game. Bye.